morning. It is day 23 today, and we've got quite a patchy section coming up this morning because for the next 6 miles, the whole trail's been washed out with all the rain. So we're gonna have to do quite a lot of navigating. So that's gonna be a nice challenge this morning. And it's all uphill. So we're coming up, I don't know if you can see behind me, it's called Mission Creek. So that's what we're heading up today for about, I think it is about 6 miles. So yeah, that's gonna be something different, another challenge for the day. There's always a different challenge. Okay, so this is the trail, and obviously that's where the trail used to be. So we're just kind of going through where we think the trail might be now. It's kind of like pick your best route. We got a hummingbird! It is so cute! Oh. Oh, that is so beautiful to see. It's my second one this morning. Oh yes, it's happening. I'm still in my Crocs. There's been lots of river crossings and bushwhacking and clambering around all over the place. But yeah, the trail kind of just disappears in certain points. It makes for an interesting morning, that's for sure. Okay. I think it's safe to say that I've completely given up trying to follow the PCT path because you're kind of in and out of the water the whole time. I don't know if you can see it behind me. So I'm just walking up the river, you know, just like you do, normal PCT trip. Yeah, this is so much fun, but it's hard work. You just gotta keep going through the water. Well, the PCT's just hanging in there on this section. It's nearly got washed away, but we still have a little bit of it left. I got my first weird little creature. I think it's a squirrel, but it's a very odd little squirrel. I think it's trying to impersonate a meerkat. Okay, I think I'm finally cracking up. Is it me, or does this tree look like it's got like a little Ewok thing going on? Right there. It looks like a little face. That is so weird. Okay, we've got an angry rattlesnake. He's proper rattling at us. He's not a happy one. Recently stopped and had some lunch, and we're now through all the difficult part where all the floods have been, so we're back on normal trail again. So it feels nice and easy. I think we're climbing about 3,000 feet today, so it's an uphill all day today, which is fine because tomorrow I think it goes flat and then downhill, and there's a 16-mile section tomorrow without water as well. So I'm glad the uphill's today and the downhill where we've got extra waters tomorrow, so that is good. But let me show you some of the trail because it is so gorgeous today. At the end of a long day hiking across rivers, probably about 20 I'm sure, uphill nearly all day long, and you're so close to camp, you're about half a mile away, and this is what the trail decides to throw at you. Yep, you've got to kind of try and get past a big old tree. So we've had to climb up quite steep and now do a bit of a butt slide all the way down here to try and get back on the trail again. It has been a challenging day, I'm not gonna lie. The trail keeps throwing things at you, whether it's physically or emotionally, and it pushes you to your limits, I'm not gonna lie. Before I came out here, I thought, you see a lot of vlogs and they maybe don't always show the hard stuff, but there is bad days out here or bad afternoons, and you've just got to be prepared that not only do you have to be physically strong, but you've got to be mentally strong as well to get through things like this. Because you've got a lot of time out here on your own to think and to dwell on negative aspects of things, but the trail does make it worth it on other days. It really does. I'm saying that now because I know I'm so close to camp, but I know things will be all right tomorrow after a good night's sleep perhaps, but it has been a tough day today. It really has. A lot of it's mainly due to all the floods, because I think there was about 6 or 7 miles of the trail that was just completely washed out, and there was hardly any trail left. So you're constantly navigating, you're crossing streams, getting your feet wet, you're getting filthy all the time. And then the second half of the day has just been uphill all day in the heat. But yeah, then you have other days that you're walking through happy and singing and feeling bright. So it's like life. It's not all a great big joy every single day. As much as you can be grateful for being out here every day, some days are tougher than others. So I know I'll be fine tomorrow. You know, I'm one of these people that I'm made of sturdier stuff, I think. I'm not someone that gives up easily. I certainly am not, and I'm not going to give up on this. But yeah, I'm looking forward to getting to camp, having some food, having some rest, and then starting afresh tomorrow. But funnily enough, when you're out on trail like this, I do find that something happens to cheer yourself up. There's always something around the next corner, or I don't know, there's just something about it. It's a little bit magical. I know that sounds really cheesy, but there's always some good to look for somewhere, and I'm sure I'll find it somewhere along the trail tonight or in the morning. So I was just saying earlier that sometimes the trail can be quite tough, and just as you'd round the corner to come to the tent site, you come across trees like this. So they're all kind of burnt, they all look unstable, they look like half of them have fallen down already. There's a lot of damage here at the campsite. So sometimes you just think, this is too dangerous. It's not worth camping in a spot where there's such dead trees. No matter how tired you are, if the wind picks up, all it takes is for one to fall over and drop on you. So I'm gonna have to climb maybe another 700, maybe 1,000 feet to another spot that looks more suitable. So at the end of a long day, when you think you're coming to the end, it can sometimes still give you a bit of a slap in the face. So I'm gonna sit here for a little while and enjoy a cliff bar, have some more water, and then carry on trekking. Oh yes, the PCT hasn't finished with me yet. It keeps putting obstacles in my way. I'm climbing over trees, hiking up banks to get round things. Still going.